Cindy W. You got the tickets.
No way.
You try to match wits. You try to hold me, but I bust through. Gonna make a break and take a baker like a stinking egg and shake it like vanilla. It's the finest of the flavors. Gotta see the show, cause then you'll know the vertigo is gonna go, cause it's so dangerous. You'll have to sign a waiver. How can I help it if I think you're funny when you're mad? Trying hard and to smile, though I feel bad. I'm the kind of guy who laughs at a funeral. Can't understand what I mean, well, you soon will. I have a tendency to wear my mind on my sleeve. I have a history of taking off my shirt. It's been 1 week since you looked at me.
Here's what I don't understand. You would think that the president would be mortified that we all knew this, wouldn't you?
That kind of behavior?
I don't know how he... The guy, you got to admire the guy. I don't know how he gets up and walks out and... You know, and then he goes around and he appears at these little functions and stuff, and people stand up and give him a big round of applause.
We know how he gets up.
That's fine.
But, and Charles and I were talking yesterday, and if you just get to thinking about it, it's irrelevant whether any of us think about whether it's impeachable behavior and all that. It's, you know, it's, I mean, my own personal opinion is probably not. But having said that, you just get to thinking about. And there's a rumor that there are some tapes that exist of these incidents of phone sex, you know. But I mean, the mental image. Here's the. Remember one time it was a testimony that he was in a hotel someplace.
Yes. Right.
It's 6:15 or 6:30 in the morning.
Exactly.
And he calls her, and you know the Secret Service are outside the hotel room door there, and somebody's downstairs. They're all waiting for him, and somebody's saying, "Well, he'll be a few more minutes."
Yeah.
And he's saying, the president is in there on the phone, What are you wearing? I mean.
It's very difficult to get a grasp of that scene, but I don't know. Sitting there in his boxer shorts.
What a way to start the day.
That's exactly what he said.
Yeah.
What a great way to start the day. So. I mean, it's just, I don't know.
The leader of the free world.
I mean, you can, it's fine if it's like Hugh Grant or that guy from Wham, whatever his name is, or even if it's Pee Wee Herman. I mean, I think if you're Pee Wee Herman or you're Hugh Grant, it's acceptable behavior. As far as I'm concerned, they go on a Tonight Show, they apologize, and it's fine with me, and they go on with their hideous careers. But
I don't know.
Weird. But if there's a God, and I suspect that there is, we'll get confirmation of that if these tapes show up. So. And somebody, MSNBC, of course, it's all Monica all the time, and they'd be the first to play the tape.
Oh, please.
Tom Brokaw, he'd be playing the tape, and he'd... I find it amusing when Brokaw comes on, and actually we had him on and we told him this, that they're doing the news, the nightly news, and he provides warnings for children who What children are watching the nightly news? Who could be offended by a description of oral sex? I mean, if you're old enough to watch the news, then you wouldn't you think?
Well, I don't know. I guess it's just the perception of going into your living room and that sort of thing at that hour.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's... I guess the little kid is, of course, they could be.
Why does he think?
Here's what I'm surprised. I'm surprised you or Rob haven't written some phony deal where you're trying to phony up some tapes, you know? You know how we do that phony stuff you guys do?
I don't know what you're talking about.
No, it's 31 past the hour. Are they there yet? We don't know. I'll do some spots and we'll come out and see.
See that one?
Oh,
she's mine.
There's nothing quite as touching as watching your baby.
And there's nothing quite as comforting as an auto service center with a big picture window that makes it easy for you to see what's happening to your car every step of the way. A service center we're seeing is relieving. At STS Tire and Auto Centers, we do tires, brakes, wheel alignments, and much more on any vehicle with four-wheel. Guaranteed service, even scheduled maintenance on vehicles under warranty. At STS, that's a difference you can see and trust because you'll see what we're doing for your car every step of the way.
Look at that. Isn't she a beauty?
Now through Saturday, October 31st at STS, buy any four Continental 80,000-mile GT8000 touring tires at our everyday low price and get a $100 U.S. savings bond free. That's right, free. Check the white pages for the STS location nearest you.
STS Tire and Auto Centers. It's a trust thing.
My God.
Let's talk about shoes. Those often clunky, blister-causing pieces of leather you stuff your feet into day in and day out. Often, the best part of wearing them is when you get to take them off. And with our new nonstop to Tokyo, beginning November 30th, you can get to the land of shoe-free living more comfortably. After all, the Japanese have made shedding shoes an art form. And when you fly the only Boeing 777 service to Tokyo, you'll want to remove them long before you leave the plane. Kick back and enjoy your own personal entertainment system with movie channels, video games, and audio channels, even in coach. And if you travel business first, you can put your feet up good and high on our ergonomic sleeper seats, all while wearing our complimentary slippers and socks. Going sock to carpet will also help you get into the old customary swing of things. So fly the only nonstop 777 service to Tokyo. Comfort that's state-of-the-art. And discover the art of no-shoe. Continental Airlines. Work hard, fly right.
I call this, the Giants are going to kick the crap all out of the Falcons Sunday night on UPN9. I'm pulled by me, Sal the Cabbie. Here goes. The Giants will stuff those birds with bone-crunching D, and Danny Cannell will bounce back and light them up like a Christmas tree. Dan Reed's return will ache like a busted-up knee, because we're going to kick the living shit out of the Falcons the end. Thanks, it just comes to me, you know?
Sunday night at 8, UPN9 brings you the NFL. It's the Giants versus the Falcons. This is one game that's sure to be poetry in motion. And every weeknight at 10, don't miss Sports Team 9 with Russ Salzburg and Monica Pellegrini.
Is this man ever happy?
That's a tough guy to please. New York's only sports anchor team gives you more than just the scores.
You almost got me there.
I told you. Every night, get the latest headlines and exclusive features that reach beyond the hype.
And the temper.
That's what happens in the heat of battle. Sports Team 9 with Russ Salzburg and Monica Pellegrini. Part of the Emmy-winning UPN 9 News. Weeknights at 10, only on UPN 9.
If you work in an office, you know about networks. Outputting your work straight to a digital copier. Effortless, productive, cool. Other brands are advertising this, but the number one maker of digital copiers in the USA is Ricoh. Only Ricoh can hook you up right now with an Officio digital copier for the price of an analog copier. Those who know, demand Ricoh. Call 1-800-63-RICOH. Beyond digital. Ricoh Digital.
For a smooth ride, you need the right shocks. And if you own a Ford, Mercury, or Lincoln, you'll get a great price on shocks now during Quality Care Fall Value Days at participating Ford and Lincoln Mercury dealers. Shocks for your car are just $69 or less per pair installed. There's also great deals on brakes, batteries, and more.
Taxes extra. Excludes vehicles with air ride and electronically controlled suspension. Prices good through November 15, 1998. See dealer for the price and details.
At your service, Quality Care. I hope I see you there.
It is 24 minutes to the hour, and we are in Bangor, Maine here. At the, at the Bangor Civic Center on Magic 95.7 WWMJ, which is our very fine affiliate here. Please welcome now to the Imus Morning Program, live from New York, Joey Pots and Pans, and Joey, who do you have with you?
Joey?
Joey, Pots and Pans is here.
He's here.
Crime fighter is going over the bridge right now.
Why is it that we can barely hear them?
He just walked in.
Mm-hmm. The crime fighter is going over the bridge as we speak.
Joey, how are you?
Oh, I never had a bad day, but now I'm with a boot here.
Why are you
in honor of a boot, I wore his native headdress.
Joey Pots and Pans appearing with a what appears to be a dish towel on his head, looking like an Arab.
It's a towel head here. We're talking about a boot now.
Oh, okay. And the designer Joseph Abood is with you. Why is he with you?
I'm the guest reviewer.
Oh, you are.
I got up at 4 o'clock in the morning to be here.
It's great when you both talk at the same time, because then we can't understand either one of you.
Well, you ask the questions.
Not that either one of you would have anything interesting to say.
Listen, I got something for you, Don. I got a new load of Depends. This is going to last you. As long as you live, I got enough Depends. I bought 17 trailers of Depends. Great, great new item. I don't know if you can use them. I don't know if you still have that bladder problem.
God.
Take some for yourself.
Oh, boy. Unless you're called a geek.
So you two, why are we doing this? This is just the worst idea, isn't it?
Well, yeah. Bo was supposed to be here, but
here
who knows?
Well,
he may be walking in now, but he paid me to come over and review the movie. Oh, God. Direct from Rios.
What you over here, Bo?
Oh, great. Great that we had this all orchestrated, Bo. Thanks for being here.
Good morning, Bo. How are you?
Good morning, Ron. How you doing, baby?
I'm just fine.
Well, now he's still eating his popcorn chicken from last night.
Let me tell you something,
popcorn
Don.
Popcorn chicken for dinner last night.
Don, popcorn chicken by Kentucky Fried. We were eating this last night, and I'm still eating it. It's great for hangovers.
Great.
Okay.
So you guys have a movie you want to review?
We're going to review two movies. Hang on just a second.
This is beyond stupid. Yeah, they are. First of all, they're not funny. Hang on a second. I'm talking to Bernard.
Okay.
They're not funny. They're stupid, all three of them. It's not interesting.
We've taken over your offices in New York here, so just please be quiet.
Suppose a good friend.
I understand that, but that doesn't
shoot you.
Allow them to ruin our radio program.
All right, all of a sudden, hey, Don.
Look at the people here, they're mortified.
Don, we're going to review two movies. The first one's going to be real fast. It's called Ants. This is a movie that came out last week, and it's a cartoon.
Why are you out of breath? What's the matter?
Excuse me, I was eating Kentucky Fried Chicken, popcorn chicken. It was so delicious.
Thank you.
All right, so this movie's called Ants. They have the voices of Sylvester Stallone, they have Woody Allen, and they also...
A pedophile. Woody Allen's a pedophile.
What do you mean pedophile?
I think we need to get in.
And it's all about these ants. Surely. You got working ants and you got soldier ants. And then they go to Insecopia is a picnic table. Mm-hmm. And it's the most ridiculous movie I've ever heard of. And what the problem with the movie is that it's all about ants and it's a cartoon. And it got 4 stars. Some rejected person gave it 4 stars.
Right.
Don't see the movie. That just happens to be a great movie out. And I'm going to step back on this one.
You sound dangerous. You sound like you're going to have a heart attack.
He does.
I had one the other day, but that's okay.
Well, just take a breath here and let's talk to Joey Ponson-Pan.
Okay.
Joey. Now, you and Abood are going to review Bo Deedle's movie?
One tough
Absolutely.
Cop. I'm telling you.
Well, now, I saw this movie. I actually thought it was pretty good. What do you guys think?
No, it was... Let me say, Joey, let me jump in here for a minute.
Go ahead.
I saw it twice. It's a fantastic movie.
Oh, you are such a phony.
It is a fantastic movie.
You're the most...
I knew you were going to...
That's why we brought him here.
You know what? I'm going to come to Bangor, Maine, and beat the hell out of you.
You're not going
to
beat this. You're not going to beat this.
All my fellow New Englanders are going to get up and defend me.
Pots, what did you think of both movies? Now, be honest.
Now, listen, honest to God, this is a great movie because it's a real cop movie.
Yeah.
You know, Bo's the real deal. There's no question about it, so they had good stuff to work with. Martin Bregman got everybody out of this, you know, got every good thing out of these actors. I'm telling you that Bruno Beretta, who did the directing, was outstanding. The movie
is a good, solid
movie. I mean, you can't knock this movie.
It's pathetically transparent.
It absolutely was a great movie.
Hey, listen. Lions, you last night gave it 4 stars.
He's a tear and turned on Channel 2. A bad gunslinger called Salty Sam was a chasing post we slew. He trapped her in the old sawmill and fed with an evil laugh.
If you don't give me the key to your ranch, I'll saw you all in half.
And then he grabbed
And then
he tied her up.
And then
he turned on the bus.
And then
a long day. Imus in the morning.
Mo, mo, mo.
The Atlanta Braves 3-0 on a three-hitter by Kevin Brown.
San Diego in complete control. Good morning, Mike Brain with sports, saying hi to the fans in Bangor, Maine, the greatest city in the world. This sportscast sponsored by One Tough Cop, a great movie. Charlie Steiner, the call on ESPN Radio. Game 2 from Atlanta. Braves go down quietly, losing 3-0 to the Padres. And the Braves have lost the first two of this series at home. Braves making it look easy for the Padres. Almost too easy. Atlanta hitters looking at obvious strikes. Swinging meekly when they do get their bats off their shoulders. There are now whispers of a repeat of the 1919 Black Sox. And that maybe the Braves are throwing the series. Center fielder Andrew Jones of the Braves was asked if this team is giving it their all.
You never know.
An interesting response from Jones. The teams have off today. Many of the players said they would spend their off day going to see the new movie, One Tough Cop, a great movie.
We love them.
The series now shifts to San Diego, the city of brotherly love. Speaking of brotherly love, Evander Holyfield threw out the first pitch of last night's game in Atlanta, then fathered three children in the stands during the game. American League Championship Series resumes tonight in Cleveland, where the Indians and Yanks are all tied at one game apiece. Amazing press conference yesterday, where Yankee second baseman Chuck Knobloch bared his soul on his botched play in Game 2. Right after the game, he had refused to admit wrongdoing. But yesterday, he did a 180, apologizing to his teammates, the organization, the city of New York, and the Yankee fans. Knobloch hopes this ends the controversy.
I hope that we can now move forward. I think everyone deserves that.
Sounds believable to me. An NBA labor talks yesterday. For the first time in 2 months, the NBA players and league meeting for about 2.5 hours, which is about the length of the movie One Tough Cop, a great movie. Players Union President Patrick Ewing spoke to the media after the session.
We hadn't met for a while. We exchanged dialogue. They vented, we vented. And we were able to ask questions about the deal and get answers. Now we're going to go back and just digest it and come back with a response.
Ewing said at first glance, the owner's new proposal reads like the Iliad. Another meeting is set for Tuesday. Well, that's sports. I'm Mike Breen.
Hey, so Breen bailed us out.
Good job, Breen.
I'm for the morning.
Hey, Don.
Yeah.
You know what Joey Abood's new name is?
No.
Joey Shirts and Ties.
That's great.
Yeah, you like, he doesn't like anything over there.
So One Tough Cop stars Stephen Baldwin and Gina Gershon.
She's
and,
fabulous.
Michael McLone.
And the guy from he's from the McMullen Brothers deal.
McMullen
right.
Brothers,
right?
Yeah.
And it's a
Frankie
great
Pellegrino.
Movie.
Don't forget Frankie Pellegrino.
Hey, let Don talk.
Nice to have you guys on the program.
Hey, Don.
In line on the way to work.
Coming up at 17 after the hour.
Imus in the morning.
As the
it is 16 till the hour, and I am Imus in the morning, and we are at the Civic Center in Bangor, Maine on Magic 95.7 WWMJ. And here now, traveling with us from the Archdiocese in New York, please welcome to the Imus in the Morning program, John Cardinal O'Connor. Good morning, Cardinal O'Connor.
Good morning, Nicole Blass. Let me just say this, Imus Noir.
Yes?
The man of the clergy have been to many places.
Right.
So I speak from experience when I say that the city of Bangor, Maine, has the ambience and the vitality of a city in the former Yugoslavia, be Jesus. Might as well be Tuzla, Maine.
That's fine.
A lot of sad-faced losers who look like the walking dead around here, be Jesus. It's goes a long way in explaining the popularity here of Imus in the Morning, Jesus.
Well,
no shock if Stephen King puts a picture of the I-Man on the cover of his next book, you ghoulish-looking old goat, you be Jesus. The winning numbers in the New York State Lottery is as follows.
We would be interested to know, sir. Right.
Why the only one, Imus in the Morning? Little taken aback to see that this nation's House of Representatives is peopled largely by morons and former welfare mothers, be Jesus. Make you sick. Between Mary Bono and Maxine Waters, Henry Clay must surely be spinning in his grave. These two dingbats actually thought the new anti-stocking laws would make pantyhose illegal, Amos Martin, if you can believe that. Geez, it sounds like Sonny Bono wasn't the only congressman ever to kiss a tree at high speed. God forgive me. Then we have these ignorant Hollywood sluts like Barbara Streisand, Bette Midler, and Sharon Stone defending the president.
Well?
Which, by the way, amounts to a flip-flop on the part of Sharon Stone, Amos Martin.
Yeah.
You remember? Wasn't too long ago when Miss Stone was shoving Bush in our faces, for Jesus.
No, that will be fine. Really, we just don't need to go
not
there.
Good.
Hello, Mr. Marr, with the Cardinal's creative juices flowing. Put together a little poem, a little limerick, if you will.
You know, I love these limericks of yours, Cardinal.
About our horny White House hooligan, be Jesus.
Oh, this will be great.
Goes as follows.
Okay.
The scandal is climaxing, gripping our nation, thanks to the liar's public ejaculations.
That'll be fine.
Some are afraid he'll get off the hook. Others don't care. He's a lovable schnook. But impeachment or not, there is punishment he's getting. These days, Socks the Cat's the only pussy he's petting.
Oh,
no.
Hey, what the hell?
The Daily Number.
Hey,
by the way, I'm Mr. Marge.
Yes.
The only NBA union Patrick Ewing should be president of is the National Burglars Association, for God's sake.
That will be fine.
Patrick Ewing is the missing link. Too bad he's not still missing because he's knuckle-dragging retard.
We just don't need to develop this any further.
Why don't you stop the bullshit shenanigans, I, Mr. Marr?
Right.
Take the mask off. It's not Halloween yet. Take the Maggie Thatcher mask off, you scrotum-faced slob, you.
I'm going to Jesus.
You hear, I, Mr. Marr, Jennifer Flowers compared her sex with the president with Monica Lewinsky's version.
I did not hear that.
Close, but no cigar. Which is the belong and why?
I like. This is my favorite part. Which does the belong
Which
and why?
Which is the belong and why? Right. A. Jenny McCarthy's breasts.
Jenny McCarthy's breasts.
Oh, man. B. Fred Imus's lover.
Fred Imus's lover.
C. The I-Man's ego. Which is the belong and why?
Well, I think clearly the I-Man's ego.
Wrong, you two-legged bag of bile, you be Jesus. While all three have been artificially inflated and would make anyone gag, the answer is A. Jenny's bosoms doesn't belong, because unlike the other two, Jenny's jammies won't make anyone throw up, be Jesus. God bless us and save us a whole lot of you. Have a lovely day. Throw
the
scumbag
out. John here on the I'm Mr. Morning program.
Meow, 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 meow.
Time now for the Imus and Morning Book of the Week, sponsored by Random House, and the book is Hot Seat, Theater Criticism for the New York Times, 1980-1993, by Frank Rich. This is a great collection of essays written by Mr. Rich over a 13, 14-year period in the New York Times, before he was an op-ed columnist for the Times. Mr. Rich was the Times' chief drama critic. He was admired as a passionate advocate for the best of New York theater. Talk to you now about A&E, which is, you know, they sponsor the national news here. Go here on the Imus Morning program. It's 24 minutes till the hour.
Today's AIM Mutual Funds Millennium Minute.
It's October 9th, 1998, 448 days until the year 2000. On this date in 1876, 7 months after his first historic phone call, Alexander Graham Bell held the world's first two-way long-distance telephone conversation with his assistant, Thomas Watson. A borrowed telegraph line transmitted the conversation between Boston and Cambridge, a distance of 2 miles. It was just another of many firsts for Bell, who, a year later, founded Bell Telephone. In 1878, President Rutherford B. Hayes became the first American president to have a telephone installed in the White House. I'm Bob McNamara, CBS News.
This AIM Mutual Funds Millennial Minute was brought to you by AIM Distributors, part of the $260 billion AmFastCap Group. Call your financial consultant for prospectuses. Read before investing.
I'm Laurie McNichol for the Nextel Communications Fan Highway Patrol.
Yeah, I'm Miss Inamoni. In your shorts, 2020 sports.
Hey, go! Oh, yeah!
Another good negotiating session for the NBA. Good morning, Mike Brainwood Sports, NBA Players Association gathering with league officials yesterday. 5 hours of bargaining. Players Union President Patrick Ewing tried to explain the session to reporters.
We had met for a while. We exchanged dialogues. They vented, we vented, and we were able to ask questions about the deal and get answers. Now we're going to go...
Ewing says reading the long and complicated owner's proposal reminded him of the first time that he read the Iliad.
That would be fine.
The two sides have agreed to meet again on Tuesday.
What are we liking tonight's Cleveland Indians-Yankees game, Breen?
Well, as I predicted, the Yankees will win the series in 5 games. Therefore, they will win tonight, win Game 4 and Game 5, a sweep in Cleveland, and come home to New York preparing for the World Series.
We were out of New York during the whole Knobloch controversy. Yeah. Well, the papers, with the entire town, at least people who are sports fans, were hysterical about this.
It's amazing. He came close to the hatred that sometimes you deal with here in New York.
It's great, Mike. Okay. Hey, maybe we want to wrap this up.
Mike Breen, resume.
This is Mike Breen saying,
so long, everybody!
So long, Mike.
Well, just kind of petered out there to nothing, didn't it?
I don't know
just,
what happened.
Well, I don't know. I think
could we not use that phrase, petered out, please?
Please welcome now to the Imus Morning Program from right here in Bangor, Maine, Dan Cashman, who is the host of the night show on WB33, which is on Saturday nights at 11 o'clock.
Dan.
We want to be your airline.
Copyright 1998, CBS Radio, all rights reserved. Imus in the Morning is a presentation of WFAN and Westwood One Entertainment.
This concludes the entertainment and revenue-generating portion of your broadcast day. We now return you to the rest of your local programming schedule, an indecipherable embarrassment of broadcasting incompetence that compelled the station to subscribe to the Imus in the Morning program in the first place. The entertainment and revenue-generating portion of the broadcast day, the Imus in the Morning program, will resume Monday morning. Check your local listings for time and schedule.
This is the 50,000-watt clear channel voice of the Mets,
Jets,
Knicks,
Rangers,
and St. John's.
The Fan.
Sports Radio 66, WFAN, New York. WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good morning at 10:01. This is Richard.
And down under, far away from the city. Wild west of the land down under, out back in the heart of Australia. Out back have a big knife, crocodile take a great big bite. Kangaroo can survive in the desert. How about you?
Out back
steakhouse. Steakhouse from the land down under. When the boomerang go, it come back. You will too.
Outback.
Outback Steakhouse. Steakhouse from the land down under.
Shoot through to the Westbury app, back on Old Country Road, west of Wanto Parkway, or any of our New York, New Jersey locations.
Mike and the Mad Dog are giving away 5 trips to...
Sports.
From Manhattan. Mullo.
Yes.
You're on stream tonight at the Jake in Cleveland, Game 3. Susan Wolman with an interview with Doc Gooden. She's coming up. Mike and the Dog coming up in 3. A&M Bagels. We want to thank them. And, of course, Dave Jennings and Billy Taylor and you for calling and listening. Stick around. You got Richard Ackerman coming up now with an update on your Fan New York.
Sports.
Sports Radio 66. The Fan, WFAN.
Man, I'm starving. I wonder what's the...
20. In your shorts, 2020 Sports.
The 1-1 is dribbled on the ground back to Rivera. He feels, goes to first, in time. Ball game over. American League champion.
I listened. I was getting the car going down to be on Larry King, and I was listening to it because the TV doesn't work in a limo. It works in a limo, but I didn't like that. I don't like Costas.
No.
So I watched the picture and I listened to the
right.
They're the worst baseball announcers in the history of the game. Those guys, they suck.
You must be drinking.
Well, no, I'm not. Go ahead.
Bronx Bombers back in the World Series. Good morning, Mike Greenwood Sports. That was John Sterling, our friend. The call on WABC.
Not our friend.
They eliminate the Indians 9-5, take the ALCS in six games. The early innings of this game provided some of the most exciting and thrilling moments in baseball history. Be a shame if you missed them. The Yankee bats finally woke up. 9 runs on 11 hits.
What are you saying?
Well, just saying what
had,
I just said.
Be there.
I was in the dressing room there at CNN. I saw the game up until 9 o'clock. And then I saw it from 10 o'clock on.
Yeah, it was right around that time where it started to get thrilling. Some great plays in the field.
Right, I saw the hand
tense moments.
I reviewed the tape of it.
All right,
but live it was excellent. Gave you goosebumps.
Although David Cone, the winning pitcher, nearly blew a 6-0 lead. Cone is glad that he didn't.
That would have been a tough one to swallow if we would have let that one get away.
No, but they didn't have to swallow that one.
That's what Monica Lewinsky said.
There you go. Chili Davis was asked if now that they've won the ALCS, does he have a new goal?
I'm going to try to stay sober.
That's a good one, Chili. Yanks now wait for their World Series opponent, either the Padres or the Braves. David Wells was asked who he'd rather play.
Hopefully San Diego. So, I'm pulling for the Padres.
That's where he's from.
All right.
What's the matter? I shouldn't have said that?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. I ruined it then?
Wells taking a shot at the Padres.
Oh, I see. I screwed up. I'm sorry. I apologize.
San Diego plays at Atlanta today at 4:20 p.m. Eastern Time. Padres lead the series 3-2, but have dropped 2 in a row. Sterling Hitchcock and Tom Glavine, the pitching matchup there. The prediction here is the Braves will win the next two and become the first team ever to overcome a 3-0 deficit.
I will bet you nothing. I won't bet you anything. Thank you for that fine report.
Hi, Patrol.
And here now, traveling with us from the Archdiocese in New York, please welcome to the Imus the Morning program, John Cardinal O'Connor. Good morning, Cardinal O'Connor.
Good morning, Nicole Blast. Here, Amy Samar, Jennifer Flowers, compared her sex with the president with Monica Lewinsky's version.
I did not hear that.
Close, but no cigar.
If your radio light sucks in the morning, you're listening to I Miss in the Morning.
Well, Amy Samar, with the Cardinal's creative juices flowing, put together a little poem, a little limerick, if you will.
You know, I love these limericks of yours, Cardinal.
About our horny White House hooligan, be Jesus.
Oh, this will be great.
Goes as follows.
Okay.
The scandal is climaxing, gripping our nation, thanks to the liar's public ejaculations.
That'll be fine.
Some are afraid he'll get off the hook. Others don't care. He's a lovable schnook. But impeachment or not, there is punishment he's getting. These days, Socks the Cat's the only pussy he's petting.
No, Sports Radio 66, WFAN. Every night on the A&E Network, Biography brings you something completely unexpected, the real life. You know what I forgot to do? I forgot to do the business report.
Yep.
We're going to play Hank Williams there, and we're going to get back to Hank in a second.
Good.
If you keep it where it is.
The I Miss the Morning Business Report is sponsored by the New York Stock Exchange. You can learn more about the world's largest equities market by visiting the Exchange Interactive Education Center at 20 Broad Street. I don't like the Padres either, by the way. So.
Well, those are your choices, though.
I know. We have the Padres and the Atlanta Braves. So
you're going to have to go
guess I'm going to go with the Braves. I'm not going to hold it against the team.
Now, don't hold him against his team.
That's right. I'm not going to hold it against the team.
It's not their fault.
Chipper and all those folks. And I love all the pitchers. Glavine and all those folks. A great baseball team. Bobby Cox, I like him. I'm not going to hold it against the team. I'm sorry. I'm going to apologize to the team for taking it out on the team. It's not your fault. It's your own by a lion weasel. It's 18 after the hour. That was a business report, by the way, sponsored by the New York Stock Exchange. Here's Hank.
back at your home across the track. You're the gossip of the town, but my heart can still be found where you tossed it on the ground. Pick me up on your way down. Pick me up on your way down when you're blue and all alone. When their glamour starts to bore you, come on back where you belong. You may be their pride and joy, but they'll find another toy. Then they'll take away your crown. Pick me up on your way down.
Quite a metamorphosis for Westinghouse from
Marvis Gale Bunt in that first inning on 3-2 when you have Kenny Lofton on a second base. I thought that was a colossal blunder because I thought it was imperative for the Indians to try and get themselves an early lead. Anyway, that's a wrap on today. Our thanks to the boss, George Steinbrenner, Fast Eddie, Davening Dove, Minko, you the fans. Till next time, Sweater and the Schmooza. Bye-bye, so long, and farewell.
Sports Radio.
And here now, traveling with us from the Archdiocese in New York, please welcome to the Imus the Morning program, John Cardinal O'Connor. Good morning, Cardinal O'Connor.
Good morning, Nicole Blast. Here, Imus the Morning, Jennifer Flowers compared her sex with the president with Monica Lewinsky's version.
I did not hear that.
Close, but no cigar.
If your radio light sucks in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Well, Imus the Morning, with the Cardinal's creative juices flowing. Put together a little poem, a little limerick, if you will.
You know, I love these limericks of yours, Cardinal.
About our horny White House hooligan, be Jesus.
Oh, this will be great.
Goes as follows.
Okay.
The scandal is climaxing, gripping our nation, thanks to the liar's public ejaculations.
That'll be fine.
Some are afraid he'll get off the hook. Others don't care. He's a lovable schnook. But in treatment or not, there is punishment he's getting. These days, Socks the Cat's the only pussy he's petting, be Jesus.
I'm in the morning.
WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good afternoon, 1 o'clock. This is John Minko to Yankee first baseman Tino.
Imus in the Morning 2020 Sports. Let's go to the audio tape.
Here comes the 1-1 with two out. A high fly ball into center field. Finley coming on, makes the catch, and it's over.
Padres going back to the World Series. Good morning, Mike Breen with Sports. Saying hi to the folks in Kalamazoo, the greatest city of the world. Charlie Steiner, the call on ESPN Radio. National League Championship Series, Game 6. Padres 5, Braves nothing. As in no runs, zero, zip, zilch, nada, nada one. Big fat zero. Braves, meanwhile, only had two hits in the entire game. That's two, dos, just a pair. Only a couple. A duo, deuce. Losing pitcher was Tom Glavine. He actually had this to say after being eliminated by the Padres.
You know, it's hard for me to sit here and say that they're a better club than we are.
Can certainly understand that. Meanwhile, his pitching mate, John Smoltz of the Braves, looked at it this way.
The only thing that makes it easier or comforting is the fact that next spring training, we're going to say the same thing. You know, next spring training, we're going to strap it on to say, we're going again.
Smoltz, a strap-on kind of guy.
That will be fine, Mike.
As for the Padres, they go to the World Series for the first time since 84 when they lost to the Detroit Tigers in five games. This year, the Tigers will be watching the series on television. Game 1 of the World Series will be Saturday night, Padres and Yankees. San Diego manager Bruce Bochy a little worried about going to New York.
I've never been to Yankee Stadium.
So Padre fan and former President George Bush had some advice for Bochy on his first visit to the Bronx.
Watch your wallet.
All right. There you go. Kevin Brown and David Wells, the starters for Game 1. Meanwhile, other baseball news, Dodgers having trouble getting a new manager. First, Felipe Alou turned them down, says he wants to stay with the Expos. Then yesterday, Twins manager Tom Kelly took his name out of the running, wants to remain in Minnesota. Dodgers have now turned their attention to a couple of other veteran skippers. Ralph Houk and Sparky Anderson will be interviewed sometime this week. And Mattel has a new Barbie sports doll. It's WNBA Barbie, after the women's pro basketball player. The doll comes with a hoop. The doll actually shoots and passes a little Barbie basketball.
And when it sees another WNBA Barbie, it drops its little Barbie panties.
No. Unnecessary. God.
And only goes for $20. And that's sports. I'm Mike Breen.
That is Bob Singh about the fat lion weasel in the White House. The Bubba Geranian loves thick blues.
President is penitent for being so prurry and sure set a precedent to be in this predicament. The memory is blurry, but he don't look worried. Gonna put the onus on for better curry. Look out, Bill, they putting you through the mill. Paul has got a new nose, Emperor's got new clothes, smelling like a rose in the grand jury videos. But the man in the cowboy hat on my morning radio says you don't need to wear the vein to know which way the wind blows. Monica Lewinsky, what up, Budinsky? Story blew up like mail from Ted Kaczynski. Blame it all, I can't stop. Say you went too far, but you was the one who got freaky with the seagull. Look out, Bill's high price for a cheap grill. Then you face the nation, confront the allegations with the legal definition of sexual relations. Say it doesn't count if it's just oral stimulation. Abdication situation, what you need's a castration. Like a Pharisee, saying this is all just a right-wing conspiracy. Taking off the rise here didn't help your career. Neither did the smear on the dress, it wouldn't disappear. Look out, Bill, you losing friends on the hill. Down to the nitty-gritty, she said you touched a titty. You know she sucks, but suck it up. Don't succumb to self-pity. And start sucking up to that House Judiciary Committee. The kill, drag you on the house floor, slap you in the sand shore, probably the worst that you'll ever have to endure. Cause there's one thing of which you can be pretty cocksure, nobody wants a year and a half of that idiot Al Gore.
Will be fine, Fred.
That's going to degenerate.
I was thinking last night, laying here, says, you know, man, I got to find me a girlfriend.
Well?
Carl has the record for the dry spell.
Yeah.
Like, Carl hasn't got laid in 2 years. And he admits that.
Yeah, but I mean...
So I'm focusing on Carl. I'm trying to find Carl somebody, you know?
Yeah.
Because this dry spell has gone a lot longer than mine.
Yeah. Why didn't you just get in the closet and blow up Bambi there?
You wouldn't call go to the Philippines.
Yeah, why don't you, Carl? That's a good idea.
Your radio sounds funny in the morning. You're listening to Imus in the morning.
There's some lucky lady missing out on this guy. You know what you're missing, ladies.
Yeah, boy, just what a smooth operator you are.
Yeah, I'm really in a dry spell here.
Jesus, Carl hasn't got laid. 2 years. God, I can't understand why the women are just not ringing your phone off the hook, Fred.
I'll tell you what a person has to do. You're going to do like the president does, just lower your standards.
Well,
just go out and get you a fat pig. You don't need to
This is Dan Rivers reporting from
Green after the hour. We're in Kalamazoo, Michigan.
We're on WKMI.
Talk to Senator Bob Kerry coming up.
Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like you.
I'm a in the morning.
Their mission is to deliver financial services that back America.
We expect to see Mr. Andy Pettit there, but I guess stranger things have happened. Anyway, that's a wrap on today. Our thanks to Yankee GM Brian Cashman, Padre announcer and former Yankee Jerry Coleman, Fast Eddie Dobbing Dover across the way, the bagel baron Rich Ackerman is A&M Bagels, and you the fans till next time, Sweater and the Schmoozer. Bye-bye, so long, and farewell.
Washington Post says that talks are underway there in Maryland, between Maryland, I guess, the district, to bring President Clinton back to the state.
Now, they're back holding hands, you know.
Yep.
So, you've seen that.
Saw them, so. Yeah. So they put that behind them.
So I wonder how they did put that behind them. Or if this is just, is this some act or?
Oh, no, I'm sure it's not.
Maybe he gave her a cigar.
If your radio light sucks in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Howard Kurtz, the media critic for the Washington Post. You're absolutely right, so...
The other reason, I think, you know, you often ask the question, how long is this going to go on after the House vote and, you know, we're facing more months of this? I think one reason it will go on for at least, I don't know, 6 months is, you know, nobody likes to talk about this openly, but the media are kind of invested in this scandal. If this thing disappeared tomorrow, you know, Maureen Dowd would be back to writing columns about shopping. And burden of proof on CNN would be looking at malpractice.
Well, you're going to pay for that remark. Maureen Dowd back around about shopping. You're a dead man. What are you, nuts?
She's been very good on this scandal.
Yeah, but I mean, she's not, what are you, Maureen Dowd writing about shopping? You're going to be a...
Every once in a while.
You pig? What are you, nuts?
Imus in the Morning on the Fan Morts Radio 66 WFA.
WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good afternoon at 1 o'clock. This is Rich Ackerman. Now that the Yanks know who they're facing...
Good morning to God bless.
Nice to join the festivities, Imus Namard.
Well?
Nice to be back in Detroit, the Motor City, Imus Namard.
Mm-hmm.
Bloody Nairobi of North America, be Jesus.
That will be fine.
Home of Congressman John Conyers. Would be better suited helping folks with their luggage back at the Doubletree Hotel, be Jesus.
No.
Along with Mary Bono, dumb bastards.
Mary Bono, leave her alone.
The winning numbers in the New York State lottery is as follows.
Good, what are they?
Hello, Mr. Lamar. Former Senator John Glenn's going into space.
Yes?
No big deal, I, Mr. Lamar. Yesterday in that interview, Senator Bob Kerry damn near went to Uranus, be Jesus.
You know.
Like John Kerry and Joe Lieberman before him. Make you sick. Saw McCord getting jealous. Good job, I, Mr. Lamar. Funny moment. He asked Walter Cronkite how his feet were. All because his father was a podiatrist. I remember being relieved that his daddy wasn't a damn proctologist, because I tell you that. How's my what? My mole? What? Thinking of outrages, Imus Namard.
Yeah.
Another filthy new play on Broadway depicting a homosexual Jesus Christ who has sex with his apostles. All the blasphemous things, be Jesus. Where the hell's the outrage on this? Where's Lars Eric Nelson when it counts, Imus Namard? Imagine the uproar if these reprobates put on a play depicting Allah humping goats or some damn thing, be Jesus.
True.
Or a play about promiscuous gay rabbis who go around Manhattan blowing every chauffeur in town or some damn thing.
Fine.
Play depicting black Jesus. How about this one? A play depicting black Jesus. Can't stop grabbing his crotch. I need some of that fixing, will you, Imus Namard?
Idiot.
Black Jesus organizes the apostles into a basketball team or some damn thing. Heaven's homeboys. Gay Jesus, indeed. The way this country's going, there won't be a KY2 problem in 2000. It'll be a goddamn KY jelly problem,
no,
Jesus.
No.
Where the hell's the outrage?
No, that will be fine, God almighty.
Good grief.
I don't think we need to go off God.
Great to see hot-tempered Ted Turner's Atlanta Braves massacre the other night, Imus Namard.
Yes, that was good, yes.
You think Jane Fonda woke up yesterday looking like she went 15 rounds with smoking Joe Frazier or Mike Tyson? You know what I mean, Imus Namard?
Yes.
Congratulations on your MSNBC ratings, Imus Namard.
Thank you.
Here's the new slogan for the Fox News cable channel, or what it should be. We report, the audience hides. Jesus. Of course, Imus Namard, I'll be saying mass over at the cathedral for baseball hero Sammy Sosa and thousands of Dominicans.
Yes.
I'll be praying for the hurricane victims, for racial harmony, and praying that I make it to me bed without a flipping switchblade sticking out of me ribs or some damn thing.
That won't be fun.
Combat pay for that gig. Which is them along and why?
Well, this is my favorite part of the Cardinal O'Connor routine.
Which is them along and why?
I don't know.
A, former catcher Tim McCarver.
Former catcher Tim McCarver.
B, former catcher Yogi Berra.
Former catcher Yogi Berra.
C, former intern Monica Lewinsky. Which is them along and why?
Well, I would think former catcher Tim McCarver. All right.
How about Monica, though?
Okay, I would think...
Wrong, you flea-bitten baboon, you. While all three began their professional careers, where a major occupational hazard was taking balls to the chin, did you?
God almighty.
The answer is B. Yogi Berra doesn't belong, because unlike the other two... Yogi never put on a pair of tong panties, be Jesus. God bless us and save us. Have a lovely weekend. The whole audience, be Jesus. Go ahead.
God all got it here. Imus in the Morning program. It is.
Imus in the Morning, 2020 Sports. Out of the audio tape.
Draw play to Perry off the left of the 30. 35, 40. He's off to the races. 50, 40, 30. They'll never get him. 20, 10, 5. Touchdown.
Lions race past the Packers. Good morning, Mike Greenwood Sports. Mark Champion the call. WXYT in Detroit, where the Lions hammered the mighty Green Bay Packers. Santos was magnificent. 155 yards rushing, had that 173-yard TD, another 80-yarder called back because of a penalty. But on the one TD run, his shoelace became untied, but Barry said he pressed on.
I keep on tying and tying until I don't know what, and then it untied, so I decided to keep on going and not being bothered by the untying shoe.
Some wonderful concentration from Sanders on that run. Meanwhile, Brett Favre threw three interceptions for the third straight game. Favre, no doubt, feeling a lot of pain. Should probably take something for that pain, don't you think?
Well, like Vicodin, maybe, Mike?
Or maybe just go out drinking one night to forget about his woes. World Series Game 1 tomorrow night, Yankee Stadium in the Bronx, Yanks and Padres. San Diego will go with Kevin Brown as their starting pitcher. Brown was asked if he's going to be intimidated by the Bronx crowd.
Screw that crowd, too. I don't give a the crowd's doing. That's ridiculous.
Whoa. Fighting words from Kevin Brown. Wow. Yankee fans will certainly embrace him. Yankee fans are a rare breed already. Many lined up all night at Yankee Stadium to get tickets. One fan we spoke to, Peter Marks, a writer from New York City, yeah. He was asked why he was in line.
My friend Thomas, he dragged me here out of bed.
Just one of many crazy Yankee fans getting ready for Game 1 of the World Series. And that's sports. I'm Mike Breen.
Thank you very much, Mike. It is about 7 minutes now until the hour, and we are still in Southfield, Michigan, where we will be for several more hours. Right? On Detroit's Fox Station, WXYT, where our ratings have risen dramatically for one reason or another. It could be that some of the other radio stations' transmitters blew up, or maybe people just, getting hip to damn in. Coming up, Fred Imus, live from Santa Fe, New Mexico, and Terry Bradshaw, probably is out in L.A. or someplace.
Yep.
And we'll see what those two goobers have in mind. I want to remind you that Jeff Greenfield will be speaking to Temple Sherry Tofalo Israel in South Orange, New Jersey, I believe that's the way you pronounce that. He will be out there this weekend, Sunday, October 18th. And, he's our guy, Greenfield, and he's very bright and very funny, and it'll be a great evening out there to Temple. So y'all call 973-763-4116 at the Big Temple out there in South Orange, mm-hmm. and check out Tofalo. Mm. Well, they know what it is. It's a Jew deal. So, same out there to get your beanie on, go out there and see Greenfield. You know what I'm saying?
One, two, three.
Want to talk to me? Yeah. Don't do that.
Yeah.
Stop that now.
Doesn't he have Meals on Wheels at home?
I don't want. Stop staring at me.
My God, doesn't he have a nurse?
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Mr. Lupica.
Good morning, Mr. Imus. How are you?
Have you read Ken Aletta's piece in the New Yorker?
No, I haven't.
Apparently, Ken is leaving his wife because this appears to be a love letter to me. Jesus, does this
Ken
guy
swallow.
Have any shame?
Well,
Jesus.
Does he have a book coming out himself?
Okay, let me just say this.
Okay.
He could easily be an intern at the White House.
Mode in the computer.
Here we have now a gentleman by the... It's very hot in here, by the way.
It is warm.
Can we get some air conditioning on in here? I mean, it's really warm.
Yeah.
This is from the Associated Press, some gentleman by the name of Michael Cuchuera. Rob Bartlett's More to Love may be subtitled a big fat comedy, but it looks and sounds pretty thin on a Broadway stage.
Oh, man.
See, I've always wanted to be thin.
The play, which opened Thursday at the Eugene O'Neill Theater, presents Bartlett in several extended comedy riffs that have little to do with the rest of the evening and would work better in a club, particularly after the audience has satisfied the two-drink minimum.
Oh, man.
That's
ugly.
That is ugly, isn't it?
That guy's a Cleveland Indians fan.
I mean, that's just...
Oh, my God.
Well, I have two reviews here that we have not gotten to yet.
Oh, you do?
Yes. The New York Observer. At last, Broadway gets a smash hit, and Newsweek says, unforgettable. Of course, they're both for Swan Lake.
Yeah.
Time Magazine says the number one theatrical event of the year. They're just talking about ragtime. And the best comedy of the year is about Rush Hour, the movie, with Jackie Chan and Chris Tucker. But
I would point out a New Line cinema film, of which I own stock, I believe. So all is not lost. How much money do you have with you, Rob, this morning?
Well, I'm going to need cab fare home.
Take whatever you have out of your pockets and leave it on the console there underneath my microphone, and I expect to find it. We'll put it by my jukebox in the office.
Okay.
So now you have to go back and do the... Here's the thing. You have to go back and do it tonight, don't you?
The show must go on.
Yeah.
In the theatrical tradition, as a trooper, I will pick my chin up and give those folks the best damn performance they've ever seen. And quietly slice my wrists open backstage the minute the curtain comes down.
So no. Have you had any conversation with anybody involved with the play, like any of the big major investors or any of the other cast members yet this morning?
I'm having a hard time getting them on the phone.
Almost everybody gets hammered in this thing, don't they?
You know what you need?
You know what's... Although I think what's interesting is that there are some positive comments about you and some of the routines. It's just... So it's not that you suck or that Dana Reeve or Joyce Van Patten.
No.
In fact, they went out of their way to say that was not the case.
Right.
What they said sucks is this stupid play, which I told you was a stupid idea when I saw it up in Connecticut and begged you to change it. And clearly you didn't follow my advice. Is that essentially what happened, Charles?
Well, I mean, based on the response this morning and the printed
media... That's right,
boss.
So if we'd have just listened to me, we wouldn't have to be going through this morning, would we? But no! Mr. Fat Ass knew it all, didn't he? And now look what happened.
I think you and Frank Rich need to see it together, and then you guys need to review it.
Oh, yeah, we'll review it, believe me.
It's a good idea.
If I feel better, can I get tickets? Of course I can get tickets tonight.
You can be in it tonight.
It's a quarter to the hour. Terry Bradshaw from Fox Sports is coming up. Frank Rich, of course, when he was writing theater reviews for the New York Times, I mean, he was the guy.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, if it was thumbs up, people went to see it. If it was tabled, it closed. He did write Saturday about Amistad. Is that the way you pronounce that?
Yes.
The film and the stage production that you saw and don't recommend anybody else does?
The stage production had the largest number of walkouts my wife and I had ever seen in a lifetime of theater going. We were practically knocked down.
If you're right, yeah, it sounds funny in the morning. You're listening to Imus in the Morning.
When will your book be out?
The first book is going to be out in the fall. The other one's going to be probably a year after that. It's the anthology of theater reviews with a bunch of updating and sort of reminiscences and actually a fair amount of reversing my previous opinions. Made a mistake about that one.
Oh, yeah, and the people you killed, of course, will love that, won't they?
Oh, yeah. And there'll be a little bit of also dancing on some of the graves. But, sorry that show closed opening night. Actually, it was, in retrospect, a masterpiece.
Imus in the Morning, 2020 Sports.
Second, Van Dyne, Favre,
over the middle, intercepted by the linebacker. Picked off for the Lions. George Jamison taking it inside the 35 to the 30. And Favre threw it right to him like he wasn't there.
What's wrong with the NFL MVP? Good morning, Mike Breen with sports. Joel Myers, the call, CBS Radio. Thursday night football. The Green Bay Packers lose their second in a row, wasted by the Detroit Lions, 27-20. It was another poor performance from Brett Favre. Three interceptions. That's nine INTs in his last three games. And it's brought about rumors once again that Favre is back on the booze. But Favre, after the game, denied he's been drinking.
Every now and then you think I'm drunk, don't you? Yeah, well, I'm not today.
As bad as Favre was, Charlie Batch was superb. No turnovers, completing 16 of 19 with two touchdowns. Lions are now 2-4, and you can count on it. They'll run the table and finish the season at 12-4 and face the Broncos in the Super Bowl. Either that or they'll be 7-9 and miss the playoffs once again. Lions coach Bobby Ross, he was just thrilled with this one victory.
There ain't no better feeling than this. I don't know what to say, but it's just the best feeling you could ever imagine. It's better than you know what.
What? Ross wouldn't specify what you know what is. We can only speculate.
Right. You making fun of me?
World Series, game one getting closer, less than 36 hours away for the Yankees and Padres to do battle. David Wells not sounding all that confident.
No matter what goes on, just be proud of what we did this year. So I think that regardless, I think everybody should be proud of the New York Yankees. Thank you.
Wells making his comments at a rally at City Hall attended by a number of Yankee fans. One fan, Peter Marks, a writer from New York City, was upset that more fans didn't attend.
Where is everybody?
Many of the fans passing up the rally to get online for tickets to see that new Smash Broadway play, More to Love, a big fat comedy.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, hey.
And that's sports. I'm Mike Breen.
One, two, three. One, two, three.
Going to advise you on a car with speed and power. It's not like you can ask.
Information comes from an unidentified government official who says the Secret Service officer and former Deputy White House Chief of Staff, Harold Ickes, discovered the president and Monica.
Doing what?
They couldn't say that they were engaged, though, in any sort of improper activity, only that they were alone there in the study.
Hi, Harold. Just boning up on a little domestic policy.
I'll bet that's exactly the way it went.
What's up?
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
Is this true, Miss Ingram?
I am not dating Keith Olbermann.
Have you ever had dinner with him?
Yes.
Oh. No, there you go.
There you go.
Closed. You have dinner with Chuck all the time. Okay, you guys are dating. I've established
no,
it.
No, we don't.
No.
We don't have dinner, ever.
Ever.
Dinner? Ever. Dinner?
Deirdre has to slide your food under the door.
Were you ever alone? Were you ever alone in the...
Here's your mashed potatoes and mashed peas.
This is WFAN in New York. Well, we got a couple of issues here to deal with. One, the I-Jet's going to land at Teterboro Airport this afternoon sometime. I don't know what time. Call Dana if I know. And I want my Blues Hawk, Gibson Blues Hawk guitar there waiting for me when
You're
I get there.
Darn right.
That's number one. Two, I'm irritated I haven't gotten that. You were supposed to follow up on that and didn't.
It's gone on long enough.
Where my Blues Hawk Gibson guitar is, where is it?
It's en route.
Well, okay.
Mm-hmm.
And two, before the football season began, we got a call from Fox Sports. They called us. And they said, would you like to have Terry Bradshaw, Howie Long, Chris Collinsworth appear each week on your program talking football? I said, well, okay, fine. So fine with me.
Acquiescing and being just...
And so now, 2 weeks in a row... We've had Now, here he is now. As I say, he's 15 minutes late. Here now. Well, let me just finish my thought. We don't care whether they appear or not. It doesn't help us.
We don't care.
Did you? We have 15 million people listening to the radio, another couple million watching television. Yeah. They might have 300,000 watching our stupid pregame show and their football games.
Who made the entree to whom?
Who's a big fan of Terry Bradshaw's? Us. We were a big fan of Bradshaw's before. We don't need even to appear on the program. or Howie Long, that big doofus. Yeah. Or that pencil-neck geek Chris Collinsworth. Anyway, here he is now, finally, Jerry Bradshaw. Good morning, Mr. Bradshaw.
I live in the country.
I don't care what
you know. My battery on my phone, I only get to charge it up every 3 weeks. It went down, okay?
What happened last week?
Last week, I didn't know I had to do the show. Then when they told me that I had to do the show, I didn't want to do it, so I just didn't return any calls. What was I going to talk about? Philadelphia and Washington? Come on, give me a break.
Very good.
You want to hear that garbage?
No.
No.
Very good point.
Neither did I.
How are you?
I'm good. How you doing?
No, all right. You know, we had to...
I'm mad as hell at Peter Marks, and I'm not going to take it anymore. Now, that's acting. That's an actor.
Well...
Where's your enthusiasm, huh, man? Come on.
Well, I'm going to come see this new version. There better not be some of the same problems that I sensed in Connecticut.
I'm sure I'll hear about them while you're there in the audience.
Oh, you goddamn right you will.
Hey.
I'll be up on that stage, you fat bastard.
Good.
Okay. Well, all right. Well, go home, Rob. Get some rest.
Why?
Here's the thing that I... pardon me for taking the Lord's name in vain, by the way. Here's the thing that you have to go down there now and face all these people, all the people who work on the program, on the show, and poor old Dana Reeves, she'll be there, and Joyce Van Patten, who in one review is described as being a...
Totally wasted.
Totally wasted in her role. I mean,
well,
she'll be happy to...
She has a couple of pops before each performance. What's the big deal?
Okay.
No, that's not what they meant by totally wasted.
Man, well... I mean, we would have been happy had they just been even mixed, right, Larry?
Yeah.
I mean, but just...
I say we have to... Everybody has to go to this show because it is a good show. And prove these critics wrong.
Yeah. Show just how off-base these people are.
Well, it is funny.
It is.
And it is clever.
Rob is brilliant.
Yeah. But apparently it doesn't work for people who... Really, you would think would know about these things, wouldn't you?
Maybe you should have worn tights, Rob.
Yeah, that's what I should have worn tights. I should have had a British accent.
Maybe you shouldn't have told them you work on my program. That would have been a helpful start. I love picking up the New York Times and seeing my name in a sub-headline attached to a brutal review. So.
Well, if you read the headline and the sub-headline, but you don't read the review, it's not bad.
It doesn't look bad at all,
no.
All right. Well, good luck tonight, or break a leg, or whatever you're supposed to say.
Yeah. Well, I think I've gone beyond the breaking leg point.
You know, here's what could happen. The theater could burn down.
The producers might burn it down.
or the lead actor and the author could commit suicide on stage.
That could happen, too. Yeah.
That'd be worth a couple of tickets, wouldn't it? Come see a live sacrifice.
It's 29 after the hour. All right. I'll talk to you later. Leave the money by my jukebox. Get out.
He's a singular sensation.
Who am I anyway? Am I my DNA?
O.J. Simpson, live on Broadway.
Don't cry for me, Rosa Lopez.
The most luridly controversial story of the century, set to the music of Rodgers and Hammerstein, Jerry Herman, Stephen Sondheim, and Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Midnight on the way to Chicago.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the morning.
I'm gonna wash them spots right out of my cough. I'm gonna wash them spots right out of my cough.
O.J., the musical.
Bloody droplets on my hat and gloves. Bloody droplets on my hat and gloves. Now ain't that too damn bad?
Imus in the morning. Sports Radio 66, WFAN.
If you're in Connecticut and you're going to LaGuardia or JFK, you have, a few options. You can hire a private limousine for about $250. I'm turning to Kathy Lee Gifford. I'm not going to, but Anyway, Bernard's out in the audience to talk to some of these folks who've all come down here. Several hundred of them showed up, spread out through the Star Theater here, and half of them have left, thank God. And they're a scary group of folks, but they're very loyal and...
Very nice.
They're probably okay. I don't know. I don't have to have any relationship with them, and they understand that.
It's a good thing
about my audience. I'm not one of those phonies who pretends, you know, that I love the audience. And the audience, by the way, doesn't pretend they love me. We tolerate each other.
Right.
And we each get something out of the relationship. They buy the junk I sell, and we entertain them. Mm-hmm. So who have you got out there?
I have this gentleman right here. Sir, can I ask you a question? What's your name?
Name's Ed.
Why are you here, for the free cheese?
No, I'm here because I can finally hear it.
Without the commercials. Without the commercials, do you think Imus should have another child?
No.
not a citizen.
I mean, we have the brother of a famous singer who I happen to be a big fan of. I've been a fan of his for years, actually. The brother of Pete Seeger, sir. What's your first name?
No. Bob Seeger, you moron.
Oh, Bob Seeger. He sucks. I don't want to talk to you. No, I'm sorry, sir. What's your name?
George.
George supplied the chairs for the I-Man and Charles.
You know, on a serious note, George, they're great.
Fabulous.
This is the kind of stuff you sell. You got it going on, baby.
Yeah, hey, okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Like a rock, you know?
George's not too happy to be here?
Yeah, I am. I came last year, too.
Okay, George, well, say hi to Bob. We have another gentleman right over here. Sir, what's your name?
Harvey.
Are you here for the free buffet or what?
I'm here to hear something about the Yankees.
About the Yankees? You want to hear something about the Yankees? Are you waiting for Breen to get on? Do you like Mike Breen better or Warner Wolf?
Mike Breen.
Is it an anti-Semitic thing you're... And then, of course, Chief, we have the only black person in the audience here. What's your name?
Olivia.
Olivia, do you kind of feel like a Jew in Baghdad at this point?
Come on.
Bernie? No, you don't? You think Imus has been a little too rough on his friend Rob Bartlett this morning?
No.
You think he deserves to get kicked in the teeth while he's lying on the floor?
No.
Well, no, I mean, we couldn't ignore these reviews and...
No, I'm just kidding, Imus. I'm just trying to go with the lady. What's your name?
Olivia.
Okay. That's the second time now she told you that, Olivia.
Well, it's Olivia. Whatever you have is catchy, I think.
Looking good, baby.
So, is this your husband?
No.
Would you like to marry him?
I am an ordained minister, Olivia, so I can legitimately perform a ceremony if you all get hooked up here.
Some jungle fever thing?
That'll be fine, Bernie.
You know what I'm saying?
Dingo deal here.
Fine.
Well, let me ask you this. Do you think Bill Clinton should be impeached as a black woman?
No.
He's not a black woman. He's a white man.
Should he be impeached as a white guy?
Should he be impeached as a white guy? Or you mean... Her opinion, I understand that.
Right, so in his appeal to the black community is what?
I'm not really sure.
Well, neither are we.
Oh, well, Olivia, we'll try to get Bernard to leave you alone. It's 21.
No.
Almost 20 minutes now until the hour here. Now. We're still working.
In the morning. In your shorts, 2020 sports.
Straight back to throw it. That's long over the middle. And what a grab! Goal! And he will score! Touchdown to Jermaine Crowell!
The Packers are fed to the Lions. Good morning, Mike Brainwood Sports. Mark Champion the call, WXYT in Detroit. Lions ripped the Packers 27-20 at the Silver Dome. For the third straight game, no turnovers for quarterback Scott Mitchell. Turning in another flawless clipboard performance. And Charlie Batch had no turnovers either, just a pair of touchdown passes. Batch tried to stay on an even keel after the big win.
The exuberance of a rookie. But then there was Brett
Favre. Why are we disparaging poor Scott Mitchell?
He's having a bad year.
Huh?
He's having a bad year.
Oh, yes.
Yes, he's down and out.
I don't want to play anymore.
How's the guy from... Carolina guy quit. What's his name?
Kerry Collins.
He just walked in and said...
Now he plays for Mike Ditka.
That'll work.
Then there was Brett Favre of the Packers. Three more interceptions. Favre was asked what he thought of Charlie Batch's performance.
Well, I really didn't pay a whole lot of attention. I'm having a hard enough time playing myself, you know? I mean, who in the hell am I to be watching other guys when I can't even play myself?
Favre not paying much attention to his own receivers, evidently, as well. Nine interceptions in the last three games.
Well, he thought that once his name was having so much success going to Detroit's... folks that he'd throw to him, too. So.
Favre now feeling some pain. Nothing a few painkillers certainly wouldn't.
Oh, that's really nice.
Other Detroit news, Tigers have named manager Larry Parrish the permanent manager. Parrish had the job on an interim basis when he took over for Buddy Bell in September, and he guided the team to a 13-12 mark rest of the way. Parrish says he was a little surprised how quickly the team gelled under him.
I was surprised it happened this soon. I didn't think it would happen quite this fast, but I knew it would because we were so unified, we stuck together.
And he'll lead them into the next season. The Tigers will scratch their opponent's eyes out.
Ooh.
It may be early, but a big NHL game tonight for the New York Rangers, who've begun the season 0-3 as they face the New Jersey Devils tonight at Madison Square Garden. Wayne Gretzky tried to rally the troops with a fiery speech.
It's up to each guy now to find a way to, have some confidence when they get
just
on the ice.
Just over with.
No, what the button?
Just blow up everything and everybody.
Gretzky playing on his birthday. He's 62 years old today. And we wish him all the luck in the world.
Yes, we do.
And that's sports. This is Mike Breen saying...
So long, everybody!
The score minutes for the hour. Once again, here's Fred Imus, who... I don't know, what's happened to you, Fred?
What do you mean by that?
Well, we were discussing here during the commercial...
I have a lot of things on my mind.
You do?
Yeah.
We called for a ranch update. Is there anything we need to know? Did you get those new pine trees yet? What are those, ponderosa pine trees?
Ponderosas?
Yeah.
We put some in yesterday. Working on a horse corral.
Mm-hmm.
Pasture, actually, be about, we don't know how big it's going to be. We hit some rock out there, so it could be 20, 25 acres. We're going to put in the foundations for the barns today, starting on them.
Mm-hmm.
So it's...
Can you name all of the horses we have at this point?
No.
Okay. That's a pretty good sign, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You have enough horses you can name. How's a little calf doing?
Fred. Let's see, there's Fred, Phyllis.
That'll be enough.
Tornado warning.
Yeah.
Lily.
We'll go with no.
We like no.
Yeah, we like no better.
I named the donkeys Whaler and Willie.
Yeah. We don't like those names.
You don't?
No, it's lame. You need to come up with something a little more creative, don't you?
Bill and Monica or something. Yeah.
Poor little donkeys had them both fixed, you know.
Oh.
So they were fairly depressed when I was there last week.
Well, wouldn't you be, of course?
Well, yeah, so...
We'll need that.
They're walking slow for a couple days.
Well, they're not as perky anymore either, are they?
Well, they're perky now. Now their mind's freed up, you know? They think about other things.
Fred, that hurts when you get your finger between them rocks, doesn't it? Never mind. It's an
old joke.
It is?
It's too old.
Yeah, it is.
Like something came out of one of Barnacle's columns or Rob's play. God. Yeah. Well, all right.
What's, I guess Charles will write some stuff for Barnacle?
No, I don't think so.
Barnacle's going to write his own column to read on the radio, Fred.
Why should he do something different on the radio?
Let's just not go there.
Leave him alone.
It'd be great if we could maybe send the iJet out there and fly you into New York and have you go see Rob's play, and then you Joey and Bo Dietl could review Rob's play.
That's a good idea.
I gotta think that it's better than what those reviews are saying.
It is better.
You know, you just get some jerks that want to say something bad about something. You know, they got a agenda. You know,
how do you explain it to them when they review something and they write a positive review?
Money. No, really. It's the politics, money, somebody they know. You know, they got a friend that's producing a play on Broadway, so they give it good reviews, you know?
It's a very idiotic, cynical observation.
Yeah, but we got to go with something here.
So right, guess, well, that's as good as that's about absolutely. As good as we could come up with.
I mean, Rob obviously didn't pay anybody off, you know?
Believe me, we investigated that possibility and came up, unfortunately, dry here. It's just too bad it wasn't a record deal. We would have paid off some disc jockey like sure. Scott Shannon. We'd be home free, wouldn't we?
We'd have a mega hit.
I'd be number one with a bullet. All right, Fred, we have to go. I love you. I'll call you later.
Think about investing in one of Rob.
We have to go. I love you. I'll talk to you later.
Goodbye.
What about all this material I've prepared?
You haven't prepared anything. That's one of the reasons we called you. I just don't know what happened. You know, I know. I guess you have a lot there. You got a business around, a ranch to build.
Too much to do.
Too many things.
Yep.
Yeah, really.
So just don't have any time to be amusing anymore, does he?
No, evidently not.
And at this point, why are we continuing this conversation?
I don't know.
Goodbye. Hello, Fred.
I'll tell you one thing.
Oh, Jesus.
What, Fred?
The Jets are never going to beat New England.
That will be fun.
Never. Jesus, that football thing was 2 hours
ago. I don't care if they bring Joe Montana out of retirement and play for the Jets. There's no way they're ever going to beat New England.
Well, we'll see. Monday night. So I love you.
I'm guaranteeing that.
I'm going back to New York. I'll call you from there.
Let's hear the click.
I'll be out at the ranch.
All right, I'll call you out there. I love you. Bye.
Kiss off.
Looking out on the morning rain.
Fred.
I used to feel so uninspired.
Who's he met, Joe Namath?
And when I knew I had to face another day.
For the past 50 years, we at Land Rover have been improving
place because George Pataki is our governor, paid for by friends of Pataki.
What now? What is the excuse?
I said it's the intimidation factor. You were complaining. You had a complaint, and I...
No, I just said when I asked Dana, I was just talking to her. I said, do you have the sheet in front of you?
Yeah.
And she will say, and she won't answer me.
So
the answer, I said, so in other words, the answer is no. She's finished answering. Rather, or if I'll ask her something, rather than saying I don't know, she'll guess.
It's a fear factor.
But I don't want that to say I don't know.
Not wanting and to say the wrong thing.
Yes, but I don't know is an acceptable answer.
I understand that, but these people...
It took years before I could get Bernard and Lou to stop lying to me about once things happen.
Right.
It took years.
Yep.
Rather, if I'd say, what are you doing, do you get some phony excuse from them? Rather than just saying, I forgot.
It's a survival thing. That's who you go.
Yes, but I've explained. I've explained. I don't know is an acceptable answer. In fact, it's more acceptable than giving me some jive.
Go right
or guessing.
Get the adrenaline thing. You get into the flee and fight mode, just like that. You have to know. You know.
Either say I don't know, or I made a mistake, or I wasn't paying attention. That's
right.
Fine.
It
happens too many times.
Right.
You can say I don't know as many times as you want if you don't know. That's an acceptable answer. There are people, I don't care what you ask them, they are incapable of saying, I don't know.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Well, it's just not true. Oh, that's absolutely true.
We'll find out.
Jerk.
Dope.
Thank you all here in Detroit, Southfield, Michigan, for coming. We had fun. We'll see you next time. So.
Yeah.
Back to New York now.
Okay.
Idiot.
Oh, copyright 1998, CBS Radio. All rights reserved. Imus in the Morning is a presentation of WFAN and Westwood One Entertainment. Some people call it a radio show. I call it a waste of 4 hours.
This concludes the entertainment and revenue-generating portion of your broadcast day. We now return you to the rest of your local programming schedule, an indecipherable embarrassment of broadcasting incompetence that compelled the station to subscribe to the Imus in the Morning program in the first place. The entertainment and revenue-generating portion of the broadcast day, the Imus in the Morning program, will resume Monday morning. Check your local listings for time and schedule.
WFAN New York. WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good morning at 10 o'clock. This is Rich Ackerman. Early on, the 56 degrees in Central Park, and that's what's happening. This is Rich Ackerman with 2020 Sports on WFAN, your home for the World Series featuring the New York Yankees.
Everybody, Russ Salzberg with you here on this Friday morning, the 16th of October, 1998. The number, as always, is 718-937-6666. And as always, seated to my right, my partner Steve Summers. It is the Sweater and the Schmoozer,
the Kanoosh Brothers,
on Sports Radio 66 WFAN, New York.
We want to.